I have to confess, this is not my favorite video. In this video, I'm talking all about snakes in Georgia. Yikes, snakes. You all are asking me about snakes in Georgia, so that's what we're talking about today. And I'm sharing 5 tips to live snake-free. So let's get this done. Hi there, I'm Karla Eisele with Keller Williams North Atlanta. I have to say that in the making of this video, I learned way more than I wanted to about snakes in Georgia. But overall, that's a good thing. And knowledge is power, right? So my 5 tips will help you avoid snakes and hopefully live snake-free here in Georgia altogether. In an effort to dispel some fear and have a little fun, I have a special guest joining us today. Meet my snake friend, Indigo. What do you think? He's kinda cute. Don't worry, he's a look-alike, but I have to admit, he's conditioned me a little. If this video is a little too much for you, I have another video on the 7 secrets of living in Alpharetta. So if you'd like to check that out, click in the cards for this video. I'll also be sharing a tip of what not to do to avoid snakes at the end of this video. And I have some fun snake puns for you too, so stick around. First, let's get a little perspective and learn about the types of snakes in Georgia. Please keep in mind, I'm no snake expert. My research revealed there are 41 non-venomous snake species in Georgia. Geez, that's a lot. Who knew? And there are 6 venomous snake species in the state of Georgia. Yikes, I didn't know that either. Indigo, what are you doing back there, you silly snake? I'm filming. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Let's get back to it. Based on the distribution of venomous snakes map, there are 3 venomous snakes common to the Atlanta metro area. The most common venomous snake species in our region is the copperhead snake and the timber rattlesnake and pygmy rattlesnake. The good news is, if you see a snake, it will most likely be a non-venomous snake. I don't know about you, but if I see any snake, I'll be running away so fast and screaming, there's no chance of identifying it. I've lived here in North Atlanta for over 13 years now and have had only 2 instances while doing yard work. I have no idea the type of snakes, and I didn't even get a picture. One of those times, I almost touched it by accident, and I still avoid that part of the garden to this very day. I know they say snakes are helpful and a gardener's best friend. I just don't want to see them, let alone get close to one. With the exception of my friend Indigo, of course. Georgia is such a beautiful place to live, even the snakes think so. So let's get down to my 5 easy tips you can do to help you reduce the risk of seeing a snake in your yard. Tip number 1, keep your grass short. You want to mow your lawn frequently because snakes are more likely to travel through tall grass. So keeping your grass short will definitely help. Tip number 2, remove their hiding places. Snakes won't want to stay in your yard if there's no good hiding places for them. It helps to walk around the perimeter of your home and clean up any leaves or accumulated debris. You should keep the bottom portion of shrubs and plants pruned. And it's best to pick up any toys or tools laying around as well. All of these are welcome hiding places for a snake. Tip number 3, remove their food and water. Don't give a snake a reason to stick around and stay in your yard. Most importantly, make sure you don't have any standing water in your yard. After a heavy rainstorm, you'll typically see standing water at the bottom of the downspout, or you could have a leaking hose that's pooling water. Keep in mind, snakes like to hunt for food, so if you have a rodent issue, you'll need to resolve that problem first. If there are any signs of rodents, it's best to call an exterminator. Also, bird feeders can attract snakes and other pests, so it's best to avoid installing them altogether. Tip number 4, use rubber mulch. Snakes don't like rubber mulch because they like soft and grassy environments, and rubber mulch is hard and made from recycled tires. It's more expensive initially, but it lasts much longer. Just this last spring, we changed from wood mulch to rubber mulch, and we've been really pleased with it. It's not a comfortable environment for snakes, so they won't hang out in gardens with rubber mulch. Tip number 5, move firewood storage. There's nothing like a fire on a cool winter's night, but that wood pile can cause a problem in warmer weather. A wood pile is a perfect place for snakes to hide, so it's best to burn your wood before snakes become active in the spring. If you keep your wood year-round, be sure to place your firewood storage away from your home and stack it on a rack well above the ground. Also, as I promised in the beginning, I have a tip of what not to do to avoid snakes. Don't put a whole bunch of mothballs in and around your yard. It will smell really, really bad, and there's no proof that they even work in preventing snakes. Your best bet is to stick to the tips shared in this video. Indigo says that if you get rid of his shelter and don't have any rodents for him, then he'll pass right by and go to your neighbor's house. Thanks for the tip, Indigo. But seriously, don't let the fear of snakes take away from doing everyday things and enjoying your yard. Just be mindful of your surroundings. What kind of flooring does the snake-loving architect design all his homes with? What do you think? Reptile. Why don't snakes drink coffee? Because it makes them viper active. And why should you never throw a snake like a boomerang? Because it'll come back to bite you. I couldn't resist. So there you have it. If you found this video helpful, let me know by giving it a like, subscribing to our channel, and sharing this video with your friends. And if you're considering moving to Georgia and want to make sure you're prepared, then you should click and watch this video up top with the pros and cons of living in Alpharetta. Or if you want to learn about fun things to do, you're going to want to click and watch this video on the bottom with our top 5 fun and games in Alpharetta. I hope you enjoy watching those, and I'll see you on the next one.